Scandinavia, where fjords carve deep into the landscape, where the aurora borealis paints the night sky, and where the Vikings once ruled the seas. A region with rich history, culture, wealth, and a deep-rooted passion for football. Scandinavia has produced several top footballers in the past and continues to have some of the best footballing talents playing for top European clubs. Likewise, football remains the most popular sport in the region. But despite this, Scandinavian countries have had very little success on international stages, especially in Euros or World Cups, with Denmark only side to win a major international trophy when they won the 1992 European Championship. The recent form of these countries is also not so impressive. Norway has not participated in a World Cup or Euro in over 20 years. Sweden also missed the last Euro as well as the last World Cup. Denmark is the only Scandinavian team to play World Cup 2022 or Euro 2024. They played both, although they did not go beyond the round of 16 in any of these tournaments. But no matter how they perform in international matches, it does not stop these countries from producing so many exciting footballing talents. And with the amount of quality this region has, it is only logical to create a team and see how strong a combined Scandinavian 11 could be. Now, before moving to our video, I should make it clear that I'm creating a combined Scandinavian 11 and not Nordic 11 or what many call a unified Scandinavian 11. So my Scandinavian 11 will consist of players from Denmark, Sweden, and Norway, not other Nordic countries, which are also included by many people in the list of Scandinavian countries. But I'm going with my understanding, which includes only these three countries. And anyway, having other Nordic nations is not likely to change my team, as most of my picks would still be from Denmark, Sweden, or Norway. So without further ado, let us create our Scandinavian combined 11 for 2024. Goalkeeper, Fredrik Ranou. I know that even Denmark's starting goalkeeper is still Kasper Schmeichel, who has been brilliant for Denmark and for most of his time with Leicester City. But he has not been able to maintain same form since leaving the Foxes. Fredrik, on the other hand, was instrumental to Union Berlin's 22-23 breakthrough season and had a good campaign in the last season as well. A great shot stopper, Fredrik Ranou is a commanding presence inside his box, excellent in positioning and does not look nervous in set pieces. Ranou also has a strong personality like Kasper Schmeichel, letting the team rely on him in high-pressure situations, putting him ahead of any other option for starting goalkeeper of Scandinavia in 2024. Right centre-back, Joachim Andersen. The Danish centre-back has joined Fulham from Crystal Palace this summer. Andersen is considered as a ball-playing defender and can play on any side of defence or even as a defensive midfielder. But he is not just a ball-playing centre-back. He is really good in interceptions, reading his opponents, and with the height of 6'4", he is brilliant aerially also. He played every minute of Euro 2024 with Denmark till their exit in round of 16. He has played almost every position of centre-back including right centre-back with Denmark, so seems fair to put him as right centre-back in this team. Central centre-back, Andreas Christensen. As I'm going with a back three with inverted winger, not inverted wing back, I'm putting him in the centre of a back three defence, where he has played with Danish team, in past with Chelsea, and during his loan time with Borussia Mönchengladbach. Even in some matches with Barca too, he was used in similar position by Xavi. We all know how good he is on ball, calm in possession, great passer, and like his compatriot Andersen, he's also tall with 6'2", and shows his presence in aerial challenges. Christensen came back to Chelsea from loan in 2017 when he was 21 and had to replace David Luiz, who was sidelined due to injuries. And Christensen, with his performances, actually sidelined him for rest of the season under Conte. Conte also highlighted how mature and composed he was for someone of his age. Currently injured and facing competition for starting spot from 17-year-old Pau Cubarsí and maybe from Eric Garcia also. But in his first or last two seasons with Catalonian side, Christensen earned his place in the starting 11 and established himself as one of the key players of Xavi's Barcelona. Before joining Barca in 22, Christensen was becoming a starting player under Thomas Tuchel's Chelsea. Equally good in both right centre-back and central centre-back position in his back three, even seen by many as the successor to Thiago Silva, before he decided to let his contract run out and join Barca on a free transfer in the summer of 2022. Christensen is perfect person to play as a central centre-back in this back three defence, using his ball-playing qualities, his calmness and positioning to avoid any surprising threat in the box. Isaac Hayne is also a good option, but Joachim Andersen forms a good partnership with Christensen in national team and both complement each other well. Left centre-back, Victor Christiansen. There are not enough left-back options in Scandinavia. Initially, I thought of going with only three defenders to get more midfielders, but a back three with only one DM might not give a defensively strong structure, especially when I'm going with two strikers and two wingers. A classic 4-4-2 or any other back four is the option I could go with, or a back three with wing-backs or with two DMs. So I'm going with a 3-4-3 with wing-backs, which can also be converted into a 4-2-2-2. As these formations looks more practical in this case, considering the four forwards I'm going with. In my view, Victor Christiansen gives them a good balance in defence and can play as a wing-back also. He regained his form in Bologna under Thiago Motta last season, and while he has a slow start with Leicester, I think he's going to be just fine as the season progresses. Although for a player in a relegation fighting team, it is always tough to show consistent good performances. But just 21, was really good in Bologna last season and looks like a well-rounded left back. He scored 4 goals in the Serie A last season and was really solid defensively also. I know he's better used as a left back or a left wing back, but as I can use only one of the side backs as a wing back, I'm putting him in the left centre back. His on-ball qualities and defensive attributes can help him to play in this position too. And in this position, he can also play as a left back when this team shifts 4-2-2-2 from 3-4-3. Right back, Julian Ryerson, a right back and can also play as a right wing back where I'm putting him in my team. And like Christiansen, he can also be used as a right back in this lineup if the team takes the shape of a back four. The Norwegian joined Borussia Dortmund in January 23, and in 1.5 seasons, he has become a default starter for the German side. A fan favorite, Julian Ryerson possesses strong mentality and fighting spirit. He's really fast, a good dribbler, plays with high intensity, and is good in physicality. He's also versatile and aerially dominant. Julian Ryerson played a strong defensive shift against PSG in the Champions League against one of the best players in the world. And I think he did well in the Champions League final also. Alexander Bach is also another great option, and I know many would go for him over Ryerson, but in 24, I don't think he's better than Ryerson. Defensive midfielder, Pierre-Emile Højbjerg. I know he's currently not as good as he was 2 years ago, and you may go for Neugaard. But I still believe he's current best defensive midfielder of Scandinavia, ignoring the current drop-off, which he should overcome this season with Lyon. He is better than any other defensive midfielder in this list for experience, positioning, awareness, and defensive actions. He can sit back and do a great job of a holding midfielder, but he still offers a lot going forward and can be a threat in front of goal. His press resistance, his passing, especially line-breaking passes, are really not talked enough. With only one DM to play, he is my clear choice over Christian Norgaard. Central midfielder. I am going with two centre forwards, two wingers, so I have space for only one central midfielder. Christian Eriksen is finally looking past his prime, so I am going with current best midfielder of the region, Martin Odegaard. Odegaard joined Arsenal in January 21 on loan from Real Madrid and then signed for them permanently in the summer of 2021. In just 1 year, he became the captain of North London side and has been a key part of Arsenal's rebuild and their last two title races. Calm, composed on the ball, a brilliant passer, and has an eye for goal. With Højbjerg in midfield, he can play as an orchestrator while Højbjerg sitting deep. Lucas Berriwal is another good option, 18 years old, and has joined Spurs this summer, has immense potential, and should become key player for his club and country in next few years. But currently very young, and we already have Odegaard for center midfield position, so I'm skipping him for this time. Left wing back, Dejan Kulusevski, did not have last season well, but we all saw his qualities under Conte. And there is no reason he cannot repeat this with Ange. In my view, he is more talented and impactful than fellow Swedish winger Anthony Elanga. So I'm going with him. I think he can fit well in this wingback come winger or AM role. Conte tried him as a wingback, although did not work out, but mine gives him more flexible and free role. Me, a random small YouTuber with no experience of coaching in any capacity, can surely give him a better role than a multiple times league winning coach. Yeah, why not? But he has played as a wingback and also as an attacking midfielder with Swedish football team. Kulusevski is 6'1", tall, strong and a versatile player. He's very quick with or without ball. Has a really great passing range and vision. I personally enjoy his movements, his dribbling and also ball striking, which for a strange reason does not get mentioned enough. In my Scandinavian 11, he can play as a left wing back but can also move to a number 10 or to a winger role in the 4-2-2-2 system. Right winger, Oscar Bob. I think he is a real deal and should become a key player for both Manchester City and Norway national team. Oscar joined Man City Academy in 2019 from Norwegian side Vålerenga and quickly became a famous name in youth ranks. Oscar Bob made his debut for Man City against Fulham on 2nd September 23. He gained headlines on 13 January 24 when he scored the winning goal on 91st minute against Newcastle United. Oscar also had a very impressive pre-season, but he was sidelined due to an injury and still waiting to get featured this season. But I'm not putting him just because he's from City youth ranks or is in the current first team, but he's really, really good. Quick with his feet, amazing dribbler and also very creative. The quality of chances he creates and the way he is a constant threat in and around the box, I am completely joining his hype train. And playing with Haaland for both club and country, he can build a special connection with him also. In this formation, he can play as a right winger or move to a number 10 role, interchanging with Kulusevski. Antonio Nuza is also a brilliant option who I would love to have in this team, but his recent injury record is a bit concerning and I want to see him playing more and consistently well. He has crazy potential but need more time to see how long he can maintain his form and show how good he is on big stages. Center forward, Erling Haaland. I mean, what do I need to explain? He is the best player of Scandinavia, a robot, a literal goal machine. He has to be here. Even if he played two strikers or three strikers, I understand debate around him for his overall game, but for me, he's the best nine in the world. His job is to score goals, and he does that better than anyone. As a Chelsea fan, I know how big a deal it is to see the ball going into the net so frequently. Left winger, Alexander Isak. He's also a center forward, but with both his talent and qualities and his form with Newcastle, I could not keep him out of my team. And he's still a different kind of striker comparing to Haaland. He's good on ball, in dribbling, has a good link-up play. So I think he can play well in a striker-cum-winger role. With Kulusevski leading the wing, you don't need to be isolated or constantly go into a 1v1 with defenders, but can be more with the ball and create more goal-scoring chances for himself and for Haaland also. I would love to have Viktor Gyokeres also, but can't have three center forwards in a team. Alexander Sørloth, again, a really good striker, a very athletic player, and with Atletico Madrid, he's at peak of his career. But in my view, he's not a better striker than Isak or Haaland, so he's also skipped like other remaining strikers in this list. For same reason, not adding Højlund too, who at this point is not ahead of Viktor Gyokeres, Isak or Haaland or even Alexander Sørloth. And that was my Scandinavian combined 11. This team might still not become favorite to win Euros or World Cup, but can surely be one of the strongest team of Europe. I mean, look at this team. It is filled with technical profiles, players with strong mentality, physicality, aerial dominance, and goal scorers. Two areas where I see them not as strong are defense, where I think it's still not elite except Christensen, and my doubt in lack of creativity in this side. You have wingers, strikers, but not an elite playmaker. Odegaard and Oscar may play their part, but still not the complete profile. Playmaker who can run the things, dictate the play, someone like Kevin De Bruyne, Modric, Saka, Palmer, Musiala or Pedri. But this is the best I could come up with, and still I think this team would be very entertaining side and a tough team to play. I liked my team, do let me know your thoughts. And if you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to like it and subscribe to my channel. That will be really helpful to me. And thank you for your time. Have a good day. Bye.